In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a 2D fire animation without using any plugins in After Effects. Let's get to it. So here we are in After Effects. I'm going to create a new composition. It will be in 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second and 5 seconds for the duration. Click OK. Then we need to add a solid layer. For that, let's go up to Layer, New Solid. You can call this whatever you want and the color doesn't matter. I'm going to set it to black. Click OK. Then open Effects and Presets window and search for Particle Systems. And add it to the solid layer. Now let's scroll a bit forward on the timeline so we can see the particles. Head over to the effect controls panel and let's expand all of these settings because we're going to adjust them one by one. First setting is the birth rate. I'm going to set it to 25. Now for the position of the producer, we want it to be all the way to the bottom. So for that, I'm going to set the Y position to 1080. And that should be the vertical size of your composition. And now you can see it's placed all the way to the bottom. For the radius X, I'm going to set it to 25 and radius Y to 0. Now in the animation, I'm going to select Twirly. Velocity, I'm going to set it to 0.1. Then gravity to -0.3. And you can leave rest as it is. Now for the particle type, I'm going to select Faded Sphere. You can leave birth size as it is. And for the death size, I'm going to set it to 0.5. Now make sure the max opacity is set to 100. And for the colors, you can choose your own colors, of course, but I've got the hex codes ready, so you can copy the exact same colors that I use. For the first color, it will be FF4EOO. Click OK. And for the second color, it will be FF9COO. Click OK. So this is our first particle systems. Now we're going to search for another effect, the simple choker, and add it to the solid layer, then set choke matte to be 10. And after you do that, this looks like fire already. Now we're going to select this black solid, go up to edit, duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. Then again, head over to the effect controls panel and let's expand these settings because we're going to do some minor adjustments to them. First one is the birth rate. I'm going to set it to 15 for the second solid layer. And also for the radius X, set it to 15. And let's change up the colors. So for the first color, it'll be FF6000. For the second color, FFD200. Click OK. Now let's also set longevity to 1.5. So the middle flame is smaller than the main one. And now if you look closely to this bottom edge, you can see that the flame is sort of floating. There's like a gap between the bottom edge and the flame. That is because of the simple choker that we've applied. So we can fix it by selecting both solid layers. Press S on the keyboard and scale them up slightly so to cover that gap. And you can see now it's perfect. It starts from where it needs to be. Now I'm going to add a background. So layer, new solid, name this one BG. And for the color, let's choose something that matches the fire colors. So something like that. Make it very, very dark. Click OK and place it at the bottom. Now let's add an adjustment layer. So again, layer, new adjustment layer. Make sure it is above all other layers. Then head over to the effects and presets window and search for wave warp. Add it to the adjustment layer. Then in effect controls, we want to set the pinning to be to all edges, just to avoid distortions of the edges. Then in the direction, I'm going to set it to 0, wave height 25, wave width 200. And this will add extra movement and variation to the flame. Then I'm going to search for turbulent displace. Also add it to the adjustment layer. I'm going to leave amount at 50, and for the size, I'm going to set it to 25. And again, that'll add extra movement and distortions to the flame because the fire never looks the same. And this is a perfect way to create extra movement. Then let's search for glow, the stylized one, add it to the adjustment layer. For the glow threshold, I'll set it to 100, glow radius 100, and glow intensity 0.5. Then select the glow and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. For the second glow, I'm going to set glow radius to 1000, that is the maximum. And now you can see the fire is very nice and glowy. And after adding glow, we can go ahead and preview this. And this is how our 2D fire animation looks at the moment. And just a quick tip, if you want to change all of the colors at once, you can do that with one single effect. So if you search for hue and saturation in effects and presets, then add it to the same adjustment layer, just make sure it is at the bottom. And here by dragging the master hue slider, you will see that all of the colors are changing at once. So you can set it to some blue or maybe like more of a purple. So that is completely up to you. So just keep that in mind if you want to change the colors. So I'm not gonna because I like this look of the fire. And once again, this is how you create the 2D fire animation in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.